guys, Elizabeth Quinn here with Elizabeth Scenes and Scents, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about my melting basket, or in this case box, for January. It's kind of a winter cabin themed grouping of bars. These guys, a lot of them are retired, so these are sort of special bars that I save to enjoy in the deep, dark winter. I live in an area where at the moment we've got several inches of snow, and sometimes our winters are quite long and quite slushy. And by the time I get to March, I'll be melting other things. But for January, I want to really enjoy that snowy cabin quality of the weather outside. Also, I have a couple of warmers. Both of these are retired too. I will be using this beautiful, it's Aspen, I want to say Aspen Grove, and I do have the mini from several years ago. This is one of my favorite warmers, and I really enjoy it in the winter time. Behind me, I have the Alabaster, which I've been fighting with my daughter over who gets to have it in their room. I don't know if it'll be staying out here. You know how that goes if you're a mom. And this is my Peace and Prosperity. This is also retired. This is a really nice warmer. It is an Element. Doesn't have any light, but it does have a little light on the back to show you whether it's on or not, so you don't have an accident. So I have quite a warmer collection, but I will probably specifically be utilizing those and enjoying them in January, along with Mr. Snow Day, my cute little snowman. So let's get into what's in my little box. So if I want to set the mood for January as being winter cabin, the very first thing that I need to be willing to melt is my last, or at least part of my last bar of Rustic Lodge. Rustic Lodge was in the Bring Back My Bar 2 or 3 January seasons ago. I got several bars. It's really good. It's almost more November than January, but it's wood smoke and oak moss and a really nice, warm, deep, rich kind of a smell. Love it. And one that's very similar that I really kicked myself for taking out of my club is Cozy Cabin. I was just starting to understand how valuable Scentsy Club was about the time that this collection, the Cozy Collection, was out for Christmas several years ago. This has bayberry and musk and just a little bit of woodsiness. This is so elegant. If you have it, I commend you for keeping it around in your club, because I really wish this would come back and bring back my bar. It is excellent, and I've only got this one bar. I may try to get through about half of it this January so I can have it one more year after that. Around the campfire, which will also go with all the other smokies. This one is currently in the catalog still because we're in January. It's come back for a couple years. Beautiful, smoky, sappy, deep, almost incense-y. Very good for the mood that I want to set for January. And it's by no means just this little box that I'm going to melt, but this is what I'm specifically targeting to enjoy. Pretty and Plaid. Now, Pretty and Plaid and I have an argument. I like it, but I don't like it. So usually I mix this with another one that is all the way retired now, is Snow-Kissed Cranberry, because this has wintergreen and some evergreen branches and a little bit of cranberry. And when you add Snow-Kissed Cranberry to it, it sort of mellows this out. And then I really like it. So it's not Christmassy. It's almost soapy, but it's very wintry. So I'll be getting through some of that. Then we have Redwood and Cedar. This is my last bar. Same Bring Back My Bar crop as Rustic Lodge and also the African Mahogany we're going to talk about next. The description on this is a cedar closet. Yes, Scentsy's right. Smells like a cedar closet. So it's sharp and very cedary and sandalwoody. Really good to my taste. African Mahogany. Now, I'm missing a cube of this. I must have melted it last year. This one is a little smoother. I think there might be some amber in this one. Very sophisticated, very woody. Mahogany, maybe even a little bit of suede, and that amber musk. Beautiful smell. Very strong, the ones with the wood in them. They last a long time. Now, Cashmere Pear. It has that sandalwood and perfume and sophistication quality to it. Much lighter. This is more like a bedroom scent. But honestly, this one needs to be used. You can smell that the oils are getting a little weird, so I'm gonna have to melt all of this before it goes bad. Rarely does a bar go bad. Lemon Verbena's gone bad on me. That one looks like it might be getting ready to go bad, but rarely. They're usually shelf stable for quite a while as long as you store them appropriately, which is supposed to be flat in a cool place. That isn't always how I store them. Ooh, okay, now, this is my last bar of Pacific Sandalwood. This is a beautiful scent. It was available a couple years ago in a really special collection. I did put it in my club. My problem with Pacific Sandalwood is I can't smell it very well. You almost have to go up to the warmer, so I keep debating whether to keep it or to melt it. I'll probably melt half of it. So, really beautiful smell. Most people love it. Just didn't perform well enough for me to keep it in my club. And then here's a pair that are basically twins. Cozy Cardigan, which is currently available. Cozy Cashmere, which was in the same collection as Cozy Cabin. Cozy Cardigan is amber silk, suede, rose, really nice. Really nice. I put 2 cubes of this in my bedroom the other day. It wasn't super strong, but it's been going for 3, going on 4 days. Just lovely, elegant smell. This one I think would be club worthy if you want to try something different and you haven't tried it over the fall and winter season. Very, very nice. So the one that's sort of its sister scent is Cozy Cashmere. This is more cashmere, blackberry, I think vanilla. This is a little bit more spunky. I don't know if that's the right word, but the Cozy Cardigan's very demure and this one's just, I don't know, it's got a little bit more attitude, but it's very good. And I have an argument with my daughters every year. Are we ready to take out Cozy Cashmere? Well, no, Mom. So now I have this and Cozy Cardigan in my club. So one of them's probably gonna have to leave, but you know how that goes. All right, what else do we have here? Ooh, okay. Now, a couple of these I just put in to have a change of pace. Autumn Hearth. This is my only bar of Autumn Hearth. This is really more fall appropriate, but it's autumn. Apple, tonka bean, some kind of smoky, spicy smells. So it is warm and inviting. So on a day where I have the fireplace going, this might actually be quite nice, which is why I put it in this box. Cozy Cranberry. Now, this is one I keep trying to use up. It's good. It was in the same collection as Cozy Cabin and Cozy Cashmere, but this is one of those, like, you just want 1 cube and then you're done. It is, whoo, it's cranberry and almond and pie crust. So it's really nice, but you don't want a ton of it. So kind of like that one small slice of really rich dessert. Okay, what's left? Snowberry. Now, snowberry is super fresh, super clean. Peppermint, cinnamon, loganberry, strawberry. Weird combo. Really good. This reminds me more of Christmas than most of the other ones that are in here, but it's really nice and it's great on a snowy day. So, snowberry. I have 1 little cube of spiced bellies left. The new Joy and Wonder and the old spiced berries are similar. If I could pick between the two, I like spiced berries even better. I saved these to melt at the same time, and they're both deep and dark winter fragrances. So I've got another whole bar of Joy and Wonder here, and it's also in my club till I decide how many bars of it I need. It is a deep, dark winter powerhouse of a scent. I think it smells the most like a mulled wine of anything since he's ever produced. It lacks the super incense quality of spiced embers, or spiced berries, sorry. But it's very, very close, and it does have that smoldery undertone that reminds you of incense, just not to the same degree as spiced berries. So I'm going to be doing that as an evaluation, getting these two and deciding how much of this I need because I can't get spiced berries anymore. So then since it is still January in a cold climate, I've got a couple of the off-brand evergreens. So I want to finish up some Just For You because I didn't melt as much of that as I wanted to during Christmas. So it's fir and blackberry, so it's not quite as Christmas as, say, your very snowy spruce. I need to finish up my evergreen grapefruit, which is just a little bit more clean smelling than other evergreen smells, so I just kind of need to get through it. And then last but not least, my beautiful Will Stay in My Club Vanilla Oud. This, I always credit Patricia Gates. She loves this. She champions this scent. It's sophisticated. So it's vanilla and oud wood, which I've never smelled except for what they say in here, and other really deep notes. So I think when I have most of these things going, you know, in layers in the house at different times, that I will feel like I'm totally cuddled up in a winter cabin with my tea and my coffee and my fireplace and hopefully a couple of really good books in January. So whatever you guys enjoy melting in this season, depending on where you live and what your preferences are, I hope you really enjoy your January, and I'll be reporting back to you soon. Have a great day. Bye-bye.